Hello everyone, now we will see the third unit, next topic. So we have already completed that, the introduction of the unit 3 in facts. That is the need of facts controllers, shunt controllers, particularly SVC and STATCOM. In particularly, so we have considered the transmission line, long transmission line, and when it is operating at no load, it is having the problem of Ferrante effect. To mitigate the Ferrante effect, so we have considered the normal reactor. When we consider the normal reactor, it is very good at a particular load condition, but load on the transmission line is not constant, it is continuously varying from no load to very light load. Let us have 25% load, then what happens, the variation of the voltage also changes. Therefore the fixed inductor is not suitable for this compensation. Let us go for thyristor controlled reactor. So we will adopt the thyristor controlled reactor, so in which we have harmonics injection with the thyristor control reactor. We have fortunate enough to mitigate those harmonics with the help of sequential switching as well as transformer connections. So both the harmonic mitigation methods were discussed in the previous videos. In the sequential switching, what we will do is we will split the TCR into different parts, n number of parts. N minus 1 number of parts are operating as TSRs, thyristor switched reactors. Among all m number of TCRs, one TCR is operating with the delay angle control. So therefore, so we will provide the delay angle control for one TCR, which will reduce the harmonics injection. So second method is transformer connections. With the transformer connections, we will reduce the harmonics. So apart from that, now we will go for transmission line loading. So when the transmission line is loading from no load to full load, then TCR is not good enough. When line is loaded, then what happens, receiving end load is increased, therefore The voltage variations of the load buses are wider, and hence we go for our controlled compensation, that is SVC, static var compensator. In static var compensator, so the generally we'll utilize the FCTCR type SVC as well as TSCTCR type SVC. In FCTCR type SVC, we have some disadvantages. One of the disadvantages, the TCR size is bulky and injection of harmonics into the system are higher. That means the total harmonics distortion is higher in case of FCTCR type SVC. So therefore, we'll go for our TSC-TCR type SVC. So in TSC-TCR type SVC, so generally we'll go for controlled compensation with the capacitive compensation. So fixed capacity is broken into M number of or N number of TSCs. Each one will have step-like change and will have controlled compensation. Particularly, the size of the TCR can be decreased to a lower level and hence the injected harmonics and total harmonic distortion is also going to be reduced with the help of TSC-TCR type SPC. In this video, let us understand the nature of FC-TCR, the power circuit and concept, and as well as the control circuit, the VI characteristics, as well as reactive power characteristics of the FC-TCR type SPC and the control circuit of the FC-TCR type SPC. So, and the control strategy. After that, we'll go for TSC-TCR type SPC, power circuit, VI characteristics, as well as reactive power characteristics, and then we'll go for the control area of the TSC-TCR type SPC, as well as control circuit, and the control circuit as well as the control strategy of the TSC-TCR type SPC in this video. So let me explore each one of the SPCs. The basic types are two: FC-TCR type SPC and TSC-TCR type SPC. Now let me explore the FC-TCR type SPC first. So in unit 3, particularly in unit 3, you have facts unit 3, SPC. So this is slide number 1. Here, let me consider a power system of generating station generating at 11 kV voltage, and here it is step up transformer, 11 kV to 220 kV step up transformer. It is high voltage line, and then this is the step down transformer of 220 kV by 66 kV. Let us have, this is the medium voltage, this is the load, variable load, and here at the load point we have the step down transformer again, 66 by 11 kV. This is the low voltage line, 11 kV line. Here we have FC-TCR type SPC. Here fixed capacitor and the thyristor controlled reactor. So this is SPC. SPC is generally connected at the load bus in general. So therefore this is the system. So in which this is the FC-TCR type SPC power circuit. And now let me explain each part of your SPC. Very first one is Q. Q is equal to QD, demand, reactive power demand, plus reactive power losses. Reactive power losses is equal to 3 I square R. I is the current flowing through the line. This is the generated reactive power of the generator minus demand, reactive power demand minus reactive power losses must be equal to reactive power supplied by the SPC. This is nothing but SPC reactive power. So generally the SPC reactive power must be leading. So during lightly loaded conditions or no load conditions, we can also supply lagging reactive power with the help of SPC. So suppose, let me take QSPC equal to 100 MVAR, the capacity of the SPC. So the variation of the load from no load to full load is 50 MVAR. So therefore QSPC can be varied from generally 40 MVAR to 100 MVAR, or even 0 to 100 MVAR, that is possible, or negative to negative, for example, minus 20 MVAR to plus 100 MVAR. Plus means here capacitive, minus means inductive. So therefore here let me take fixed capacitor of capacity 100 MVAR, and the TCR capacity may be higher. So sometimes it may be 120 MVAR. 120 MVAR. Here I have taken only 60 MVAR when SPC is operating in only capacitive mode. If it is if it is not capacitive mode, then it is 120 MVAR. Therefore, you can have -20 MVAR at inductive operation. So therefore, let me take this 60 MVAR is only considered for the capacitive compensation alone. Otherwise, it is 120 MVAR. So therefore, the TCR rating is bulky, and therefore THD content or THD produced by the TCR is a higher value. And the TCR current is given as fundamental inductive current. It is function of alpha. It is given by V by omega L into 1 minus 2 alpha by pi minus sine 2 alpha by pi. So this is the SVC fixed capacitor and thyristor controlled reactor type SVC. Alright. Now let me explain the FCTCR type SVC, VI characteristics of SVC, FCTCR type SVC. So in the VI characteristics, the x-axis is, this is the inductive current IL, this is the capacitive current IC, left side, negative side, and y-axis voltage V. So if you look at the TCR, thyristor controlled reactor, this is the BL maximum is the maximum allowable susceptance of the TCR. This black hatched portion is the operating zone of the TCR, which has limits on x-axis as well as y-axis. X-axis limit is IL maximum, that is TCR allowable maximum current. So here it is VL maximum, TCR allowable maximum voltage. Similarly, here capacitive side, you have BC is the susceptance of the fixed capacitance, and IC max is the current, maximum allowable capacitive current, and VC maximum is the maximum allowable voltage, capacitive voltage. So this hatched portion is the operating area of the fixed capacitance. This entire region is the hatched portion is the operating area of the FCTCR type SVC. These characteristics are known as VI characteristics of SVC, which has limitations on capacitive side as well as inductive side. This is the second slide. Now look at the VI characteristics of SVC, FCTCR type SVC. These are the VI characteristics, the operating VI characteristics of the SVC. Already you have seen here the leading side, this is the lagging side, and this is V minimum, generally the capacitor limit. So V maximum, generally inductive limit, just you have seen now. So this is the IC max, this is the IL max. So this operating linear range of the SVC is generally operating zone of VI characteristics. This is the acceptable voltage band of the system. In general, we will operate the SVC in linear operating zone, this zone. For linear operating zone, SVC, whether it is FC TCR type SVC or TSC TCR type SVC or STATCOM, everything is good except few differences. We'll focus on those differences later. Now, this is the operating zone of the SVC. We'll operate the SVC within the limits V minimum, V maximum limits. So, if any by any reason, if operating zone fall down out of this zone, so the SVC operation is not acceptable. That means when voltage is very low during fault conditions, the reactive power support of the SVC is also very limited, which cannot be accepted. Now, let me explain the design and equations of FC-TCR type SVC. This is the IC maximum. IC maximum is equal to QFC, fixed capacitance, the reactive power supplied by the fixed capacitance is QFC divided by rated voltage of the system or nominal voltage of the system will give you the IC maximum. So this IC maximum is calculated from here. Next one, in the power circuit you need to calculate the capacitance value. That capacitance value can be calculated by using XC is equal to capacitive reactance, which is given by V rated nominal voltage of the system divided by IC maximum. So nominal voltage divided by this IC maximum gives you the XC value, capacitive reactance, which is nothing but 1 by omega C. XC is equal to 1 over omega C, from which you can obtain the C value. So you can obtain C value 1 by XC into omega. 1 by omega C is the XC, and C is calculated as 1 by XC omega. Similarly, you need to calculate inductive side. So IL maximum is the inductive current, or TCR current can be calculated as ITCR equal to QTCR divided by rated voltage or nominal voltage. From ITCR, we can calculate IXTCR or XL, which is given by rated voltage divided by IL maximum. This is not VL. So this is V rated divided by IL maximum. V rated by IL maximum is equal to omega L. So therefore L is equal to XL by omega, generally omega 340. So L is equal to, sorry, this is L, inductance is equal to XL over omega. XL over omega. So like that you can calculate the values of FC-TCR type SVC, or you can design the FC-TCR type SVC required for your applications. This is the slide number 3. Now let me concentrate on reactive power characteristics of the FC-TCR type SVC. Here FC-TCR type SVC power circuit, So fixed capacitance and parasitic control reactor, this is IC, this is IL. IC is the capacitive current, IL is the inductive current. The summation of these two, IC minus IL alpha, gives you the ISVC. So this is FCTC type SVC. So now let me explain reactive power demand versus reactive power output characteristics. So this is the reactive power demand on the x-axis, lagging, that is lagging reactive power demand. This is the leading reactive power demand, and y-axis reactive power output of the SVC. So this is the QC, the reactive power supplied by the fixed capacitor is constant. QC is constant. QC is equal to, so XC into, QC is equal to IC, current IC maximum into nominal voltage. IC maximum already have calculated. Okay. So QC is equal to IC maximum into V rated. IC maximum into V rated. This is the QC. So IC maximum is equal to V rated by XC. V rated by XC. Therefore, QC is equal to V rated square over XC. So, therefore, previously have seen the VI characteristics. During fault conditions, V operating voltage will be fall down to a low value, 0.3, 0.2, 0.4, like that. When operating voltage is fall down, the QC, the reactive power supplied by the capacitance, is also decreased to a lower value. So therefore, during fault conditions, the operation of the SVC is not acceptable. So this is the QC. And second one, QL, inductive reactive power offered by the TCR, is varying. QL is equal to V into I LF, fundamental TCR current, which is a function of alpha. It is varying approximately like this. So therefore, this is the QL, this is the QC, then you will get the Q is equal to summation of QL minus QC.